गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन गोपीनाथ जी महिला कॉलेज सीहोर। माय नेम इज प्रोफेसर अजय डोडिया। टुडे वी लर्न सिलेबस ऑफ BSM 5 कंपलसरी इंग्लिश। यूनिट नंबर 1 एस्ट्रोनॉमी आवर पिक्चर ऑफ द यूनिवर्स। एस्ट्रोनॉमी इज द वर्ड very excited for any people and any students. Everyone to know about astronomy's rules, regulations and its secrets. So today we learn what is astronomy. Astronomy is one of the oldest science. That means one kind of science. As a one types of science, astronomy is the study of the sun, moon, stars, planets, comets, gas, galaxies, dust and other non-earthly bodies and phenomena. Astronomy is a natural science that is the study of celestial object. We discussed about universe and solar systems and we learn about all the planets and their atmosphere and their rotation things, rules, regulation things and other satellites. We will know importance of astronomy and its secrets too. Today we discussed only syllabus, but we discussed deeply in astronomy words in next our lecture. Unit number 2, information technology, a very short history of computer ethics. This topic is very large, like a ocean, but here we discussed and learn only very short history of computer ethics. Ethics means in Gujarati Naitik Shastra. So we discussed about computer and its regulations, rules of history. Professor Norbert Wiener came up with the field of computer ethics in the year 1940. It was basically founded to track an aeroplane and to calculate its trajectory. He developed a new branch of science called cybernetic. It is the science of information systems. So we discussed only informations about technology. So this lesson is based on only on technology of computer. Ethics is a set of moral principle. Once again, ethics is a set of moral principle that govern the behavior of a group or individual. Therefore, computer ethics is a set of moral principle that regulates the use of computers. Some common issue of computer ethics include intellectual property rights, privacy concerns, and how computers affect society, and the computers generation, first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, and fifth generation. As you know, five types of computer generation, starting with the big room with the computer, and today we see the size of very small laptop size computer. Computer ethics is a part of a practical philosophy which deals with how computing professionals should make a decision regarding professionals and social conduct. More deeply discussed in next lecture. Unit number 3, travel and transport, the climb to Annapurna. Annapurna, the 10th highest peak in the world. I repeat, Annapurna, the 10th highest peak in the world and the height 8091 meters among the 30 peaks in the 55 kilometers long Annapurna massif is a very special peak in the Nepal. The peak is a special because it is the first 8000 meter peak that was successfully climbed by a team led by Morris on June 3, 1950, which is even before the official ascent of Mount Everest by Tenzing Norgay and the Edmund Hillary. Also, the Annapurnas are considered the world's most dangerous mountains to climb as they are very much prone to avalanches and all the available routes pose several difficulties as the climbers have to pass through big ice cliffs and crevasses. The western and the northwestern slopes are bound by glaciers that draw off into a great gorge cut through the Himalayan mountains by the Kale Gandaki River, separating dwellings in the Annapurna. The Annapurna expedition is total is 53 days. Expeditions. About 32 days are required to climb up and down the summit from the Annapurna North Base Camp. So this is expeditions is a very dangerous for any climber, and we more and deeply discussed in our next lecture. Unit number 4, the gold frame. This story is very humor and also comic play. Very short stories. The Gold Frame is a short story written by the cartoonist R.K. Laxman. In this story, the writer tries to bring out the characteristics of Indian middle class. So this is a story related with middle class people. The hypocrisy and the false prestige typical to middle class are well exposed in these stories. So middle class people, the style of the story is consistent with the theme of humor. The modern frameworks is an extra large wooden packing case placed in between two other shops. Datta, the hero of the story, the owner of the modern frameworks, in the central figure in the story. He was a lean man with silver rimmed glasses and color of the season timbers. He was a silent and hardworking man. So as a short note of Datta asking in your question paper, he spoke very little and discouraged casual friends and idle gossip. Once a customer approached Datta to get an old photograph framed in the best possible frame, he respects, admires and praises the old man, which makes one believe that the man in the photograph must have been an idle human being. The customer is great for his ability to recognize and respect such a humanity. The customer has no will of his own, so Datta comes to his rescue of help him select a proper frame. With his help, he selects cut mounts of his photograph. The customer talks as if it were his life's mission to get the photographs framed, but he does not even likes to pay the price quoted by Datta. After getting the price, the date selected, he goes away. His customer came days in the advance and went away disappointed, or came months later. Some never turned up at all and their pictures lay unclaimed in box. Thus, Datta would not begin his work unless his customers came twice before the date of the due. His tall and rustic looking customer appeared after 10 days to see the progress in work. When Datta grasped the interest of his customer in the frame, he took out the photograph to frame it. Datta accidentally spills enamel paint on the scattered photographs of the customers. He tries to rub it with a piece of cloth, but the figure peels off. The respectable old man's face turned into thick black specks sticks to the enamel smear.